everybody, it's Christine, and I am joining a big group of card makers today in a video hop with Just Cards, and we are focused on making masculine cards today. So I am working with some stuff from Hampton Art. I am using the Too Cool for School stamp collection from Jelly Bean Soup, and I am starting things off with this stamp that looks like a part of a video game controller, and I am just stamping a background. So all I'm trying to do here is kind of create like a grid pattern with this cross shape. And I'm eyeballing it. I'm not doing any exact measuring. I'm just trying to get it as close as I can, because by the time I add in the coloring and everything, if I'm off by just a smidge, it's really not going to be a big deal. So you can see I'm just using a simple wooden, or not wooden, acrylic block, and I am just going around and stamping that on there. I did originally think I might try my stamp press with it, but I decided for this purpose, I liked just using the acrylic block better. Now, if you're looking at this and going, okay, but why are you stamping on an 8.5 by 11 sheet? Well, I wanted to stamp more than I actually needed, so that way I could cut off any, you know, if there was a part that I wasn't really happy with the straightness and whatever, or if I got a smudge or whatever. You know, these things, they all happen with stamping. There's a little bit of room for error, and so I was trying to be proactive in that and have more than I actually needed. So you can see I've got this whole background stamped now, and literally I'm just leaving a space in between. I got into a pretty good rhythm with the pattern as I went. And I'm using Ranger ink here, just a black archival ink, nothing fancy by any means, but one that I just like. It always stamps really well for me. It's definitely one of my favorite ink pads out there. So now I'm gonna go ahead and trim it down to 4.25 wide and by 5.5. So about the size of an A2 card cover. And I am gonna actually trim it smaller than that later, but I wasn't really exactly sure which direction I was gonna be going, how much of this I was gonna use. So the next thing I'm gonna do is just take some alcohol ink markers, and I am going to color in each little button with a different color. So I specifically based it around the colors that are found in the Too Cool for School collection from Jelly Bean Soup. So you can see I am sticking with like the left-hand triangle is always blue, and I'm going to do that throughout. And then I'm going to add in some kind of lime green color for the right-hand triangle. And then I will work in some yellow for another triangle up top. And then my final color choice for bright colors is going to be orange. Again, these are all found in the Jelly Bean Soup Too Cool for School collection. Knowing that I might want some patterned paper for it or something, I wanted to stick in that color scheme. Now, if you're going with a totally different direction and using these stamps from Too Cool for School but not using the papers necessarily, go with whatever colors you like. Go with whatever colors match your kiddo's video game controller or your husband's video game controller. We won't pretend like they're just for the kiddos, right? Now you can see I'm just finishing my coloring off with adding in some gray there on that circular part. And you can see each individual game controller there is coming out. Now, this has ended up creating a really cool patterned paper. Very simple, nothing really complicated here. Just a little bit of practice on the stamping, and then I was ready to roll with it. Now I'm going to attach it with my Easy Runner Grand, but what you're going to see here in a minute is I'm going to reload my Easy Runner Grand. It ran out, as you could see there just a minute ago, right as I was on camera, and I knew, yes, I could shut off the camera and we could ignore that and I could replace it, but I also want you to see how easy the Easy Runner Grand is to reload and the reason that I love it so much. And so I am going to show you that here in just a moment. I have a cartridge right next to my desk and I'm going to pull it out and just put it right in real quick and easy. Now, I've also stamped a sentiment here, and I'm going to get that ready to go, but in order to do that, I need my Easy Runner working again, and so I'm gonna pull that out. Now, these Easy Runner Grands, let me talk about them for a minute. They come with a 150 feet of adhesive in it, and it's just a straight up
nice and simple reload. So you can see I pulled it out really easy, and I'm just gonna locate my hole, pop it right in, close it, and I am ready to roll. Nothing tricky at all about it. So, you know, little details behind the scenes, but I thought it would be cool for you to see if you've never seen how easy that one is to use, just how easy it is. Now, the last thing I'm gonna do on here is I'm gonna take some black enamel dots and randomly put them into some of the open squares. This was a really important final part to this. It really gave it that video game computery look, I think, and being random with it, not doing it on all of them, up to that even more. So there you have it, my simple but fun masculine card using some stamping and enamel dots for Hampton Art. Thank you so much for being here. Be sure to check out the next video on this hop, and we'll see you next month.